Good morning. Today we are going to study how to write a C program to reverse a given number. We will open a new file in Turbo C editor and we will mention the name of the program into the comment. We will mention the program name. We will write a program name in the beginning. C program to reverse a number. We'll start with the header files hash include stdio.h and another header file is hash include conio.h. Then we'll open a main program by writing void main. Once you enter into the main program, you have to declare the variables required to perform this program. So we need a number from the user, so we require an input variable, and to store the result into we need a output variable also. So we'll take integer and comma, then one more variable that is remainder to process, and one variable to store the result, that is reverse variable, which is going to store the result of the program. So initial reverse we are assigning it to 0. Then clear the screen to print the output of this program on a fresh screen. Now our job is to take the input from the user. Just prompt a message to the user. Enter the number to be reversed by using scanf statement. Read that number. % D is the format specifier that we use to read the integer number from the user and store that number into variable n. Now we got the input. To process, we use the while loop here. While n greater than 0 is the condition we are writing for to reverse the number. The first line into the logic is remainder. We have to find the remainder by using the formula remainder equal to n mod 10. After that, another line is reverse equal to reverse into 10 plus current remainder, that is stored in remainder variable. After that, update the n value by n equal to n by 10. So this three line logic we need to perform the reversal of a number. Now we'll understand the meaning of each and every line written into the while loop. We'll perform the while loop till n becomes 0 and n, or n is greater than 0. The first line will into this logic is remainder, finding the remainder after division. So we'll take the mod of that particular number by 10. The meaning of this line is we want to split the digits from the given number. It always pick the last digit from the given number. After that, in the next line, this reverse equal to reverse into 10 plus remainder line shift the digit to its proper place. This line is basically used to shift the digit to its proper place. Then to increment n variable for iteration, we update n value by 10. So likewise, this loop gets terminated only when n is equal to 0 or n becomes negative. So after processing, we'll print the output of the program in this line using printf statement. We'll print the message reverse number equals to percentage d, and it is stored into the variable reverse. To stop the program, we use fcs statement, and it is basically used to hold the output somewhere on the screen. I will also do the hand run of this program by using the multi-line comment. Consider the user entered the number 123. In iteration 1, when it comes to the while loop, in iteration 1, the condition is true. It allows you to execute the 3-line code written into the while loop, where the first line remainder becomes 123 mod 10, that becomes 3. Remainder after division is 3. In the next calculation, reverse equals to 3 into, sorry, reverse was 0, 0 into 10 plus current remainder is 3, and n becomes 123 by 10 is equals to 12. So at the end of the iteration number 1, we have the n value as 12. So when it goes back to check the condition of the while loop, n is 12 and the condition again is 2. For iteration 2, n is 12, remainder becomes 12 mod 10, that is 2, reverse equals to reverse was 3 in the last iteration into 10 plus the current remainder, that is 2, this condition goes to 32. And in the next line, n value gets updated by 10, that is 12 by 10, and this is 1. This division results into 1. So it allows you to go to further iteration number 3, because our n value is greater than 0. Here in iteration number 3, n value is 1. Then remainder equals to 1 mod 10, and that is 1. Reverse equals to reverse was 32 in the last iteration into 10 plus the current remainder 1, and the total goes to 321. N value is updated by 10, so that is 1 divided by 10 is equals to 0. Now if you try to go back and to check the while loop condition, now n value becomes 0 and the while loop condition becomes false. So this stops the execution of this loop and print the result here with the help of this printf statement, that is reverse number equal to 321, and the original number was n equal to 123 given. The reverse number is 321. I will try to execute the program and check the result. So the compiler is asking us the number. So suppose we entered 123. If I press enter, we'll see the reverse number is 321. Again compile the program and try to insert some other number, say 243. The reverse number must be 342. So the reverse number is 342. We used while loop into this program because it is not known to the user how many times this loop is going to execute. So we don't know how many digit numbers consists of, and the user is going to enter any number digit into the number. Suppose the number entered by the user is 2 digit, then this while loop requires 2 iterations. If the number entered by the user is 3 digit, this loop will take 3 iterations. If the number entered by the user is 4 digit, then it will take 4 iterations. Totally depends upon the number of digits present into the given number. That's why we cannot use for loop to solve this, but we can easily solve this type of problems using while loop or do while loop. Thank you for watching the video.